questions from people, the public, when they ask you what you do for a living. You know, it was different. I like being outside, so it's that's a plus. But just being outside and doing what you do day in and day out, it it gets to you, you know?
It does over time.
Yeah. You know, I mean, we see hundreds of funerals in a day or a week, a year. You know, you guys might go to a funeral once every couple of years. We see it all the time. So it's a little different for us. You're doing something for the public. You're helping the public out. So it's a different type of job. You know, you have to have thick skin. You know, you see the moms crying, they're burying their babies. You see the husbands or wives crying because they're burying their spouses. It gets to you. There's competition between all the cemeteries. People spend a lot of money on their dead loved ones. You know, versus as far as wreaths, grave blankets, flowers in the summertime, headstones, cutting the grass, keeping the grass up, coming out and watering it. A lot of people spend a lot of time here. You know, so there's definitely a lot of competition between our association and other cemeteries. I think we had our first tractors in here in the 60s, maybe even the 50s. Prior to that, they were dug by hand. The ones that we dig by hand now are babies and cremations, unless the ground is too hard, and then we have the tractors dig them. So other than that, I mean, everything's done with machines. Happens is the funeral home will call us and let us know that so-and-so died, and then we'll look them up, and if they have a burial plot here, we put them on the day sheet. We go about putting them, you know, you go out there, you'll stake it, they'll come and dig it and stuff like that. If you don't own a burial plot, then the family has to come in and pick one out. All you're burying is a body. The soul or whatever else is gone. It's just a body. There's nothing gonna, it's not gonna come out of the ground. It's not gonna, you know what I mean? It's just Hollywood is all that is. The zombie stuff, that's just all Hollywood. People have their own beliefs, you know? You can't change some people. You can just tell them that doesn't happen. You know, people even now ask us if we see anything. You know, do you look in a casket? Do you open a casket? No, we don't. I don't want to see that any more than you do. You know what I mean? It comes in here, the casket's locked. If you want to open it, you have to sign a waiver. I don't want to see what's inside there. It's just not what I do. I do my job. Put the casket in the vault goes in the ground. There's no, you know, there's no taking jewelry off. There's no, you know, digging it up after you guys leave and looking at it. There's none of that goes on. You know, a lot of people think that, oh, my, I buried my grandfather with his watch. You guys probably took it. No, we don't take that stuff. We don't even look at that stuff. Yeah. The olden days, their superstitions, they say, you know, how do I know that you're not going to open that casket after I leave? Well, you're welcome to stay. How do I know you're not going to dig it up after I leave? We don't do that here. No place that I know of does that. This cemetery, any other cemetery, doesn't do that. No, I don't fear death.
No.
It's all going to happen to every one of us. Sometimes I feel like something's watching over me, you know, but karma is what it boils down to. I try to do the best job that I can during the daytime, and I have a good family life, so, you know, there's a few things I'd like to see before I die, but, you know, it's going to happen, so if it happens tomorrow, then it happens tomorrow. What are you going to do? I want to see grandchildren. You know, I want to see my kids grow up, but if that's not possible, then hopefully I've done my job with them to this point.